Welcome to the Gadget 360 show. My name is Rajiv Makni, and this is our 360 degree look at all the coolest things coming in from the world of gadgets and gizmos. So we have a lot of stuff happening on the show. We've got a new laptop from me. This is the e-learning edition, 14-inch. Very, very interesting price, about 35,000 rupees for this. But is it worth that price? I mean, it's a good-looking laptop for sure. But what did they compromise on? Is it too basic? Is it absolutely right? Is it value for money? We'll find that out. Then we'll move on to this. Skull Candy comes up with a brand new TWS headset. They call it the Sesh Evo. Lots of cool things, three different modes for sound and everything else. Good-looking ones, very, very good price, about 4,500 rupees. And it has a 24-hour battery life, including the case. And then we've got Samsung's UV sterilizer. This is, as I always have been saying, this is a device I think no one was going to be buying unless the pandemic actually made its way into our lives. And now it's a very, very hot-selling item. But this one also has an additional feature. It can also wirelessly charge your phone. That and a whole lot more happening on the Gadget 360 show. Of course, before we get started with all that cool stuff and give you our opinion and reviews on it, let's take a look at all the news coming in the world of gadgets.
Apple lovers rejoice as a new report is indicating that the 2021 iPad Pro versions will be the first ones to move away from LCD screens and get the OLED treatment. iPads have had LCD screens from day one, and this move to incorporate OLED screens is a welcome addition. Having OLED panels means the iPads will now get even brighter. This transition is also likely to result in a change in naming convention, as Apple will move away from liquid retina displays on the iPad and give a name that's more indicative of OLED screens. Barely a few days after seeing a rollable smartphone, we might soon witness a rollable laptop. LG has filed patents that indicate that a rollable laptop may not be such a distant reality. As reported, the laptop seems to have a display that can unroll between 13.3 and 17-inch sizes. The patent also indicates that the laptop will have a foldable keyboard as well as a touchpad. We should take this news with a pinch of salt, as LG hasn't yet made any official announcements.
Let's start off with our top story, which is the Mi e-learning edition, their 14-inch laptop. Very interesting price, but it is pretty much a basic laptop. The interesting thing also is that Mi is a new entrant to the laptop market here in India. They've been doing it in China for a while. But now that they've come in, they really seem to be in a bit of a hurry to make sure they get their portfolio right. In fact, there is a rumor that lots more coming in this particular category from them. But what do you get for a 35,000 rupee laptop? And how is it when you actually compare it to the competition? Well, this is pretty basic. I mean, it's not too bulky, which is great, because most laptops in this 25 to 35,000 rupee market are usually very bulky and quite ugly. This is good looking. Screen is okay, nothing to write home about. Ports are all there that you want. Battery life is fine. The processor is an i3, so you're not really going to have a rocket in your hand. You're not going to be editing 4K video on this. But I think for everything else, besides doing some heavy-duty tasks, this is a pretty good option.
Xiaomi successfully created a solid buzz ever since it entered the PC market with its lineup of Mi Notebooks. Recently, the tech giant decided to expand its portfolio with Mi Notebook 14e Learning Edition. Keeping the ongoing pandemic in mind, Xiaomi is pitching the new laptop as a worthy companion for students and professionals who spend the majority of the day interacting with their PCs. With Xiaomi offering this laptop at a very competitive price of ₹34,999, we're excited to see what this machine can do. The Notebook 14e Learning Edition has a stunning design. The metallic body looks beautiful, and it's very difficult to say that this is a budget laptop. The form factor of this compact 14-inch machine has surpassed our expectations. The lightweight design makes it very easy to hold and carry around. On the left side of the laptop, we get two USB ports, a power port, and even an HDMI port. Turning the laptop around, we see another USB port and a 3.5mm headphone jack. The absence of a USB Type-C port is a little disappointing. Turning on the Mi Notebook 14e Learning Edition, we're greeted by Windows 10 Home out of the box. Powering the laptop is Intel's 10th Gen i3 processor. Yes, the hardware on this machine is as basic as it can be. That being said, day-to-day tasks like typing, attending video calls, watching content is a breeze on this laptop, all of which we will show you in a while. The laptop boots up in a flash and conveys data in a matter of minutes, all of which is possible thanks to the 8GB DDR4 RAM. Xiaomi offers this laptop with only one storage option, which is the 256GB of SSD storage. Typing on the Mi 14e Learning Edition is really fun. You can type for hours on this laptop without straining your hands. The keys are soft and the travel time between them is satisfactory. You also get a good variety of keyboard shortcuts on the laptop, making your work easier one tap at a time. The laptop does miss out on a backlit keyboard, which is a feature very dear to users. With video calling taking up a large part of our day, it is important that our laptop has a good webcam. The 14e comes with a 720p HD camera inbuilt. Expecting stellar quality out of it won't be fair, especially looking at the price point. The camera is good enough to get the job done and it doesn't lag while you attend those long online classes or even meetings. Watching content on this budget laptop is not half as bad as we expected. The speakers are loud and clear. The 14-inch 1920x1080p FHD anti-glare display has great colors. Unfortunately, that's where the media curve for this laptop stops. The presence of Intel UHD Graphics 620 GPU doesn't make it a gaming laptop in any way. The baby 3220 mAh battery on board will last about 5 to 6 hours easily. You also get a 65-watt charger with the laptop that can charge the battery up to 50% in a matter of 30 minutes. We decided to put this claim to the test, and it was true. Fast charging in this budget is a sought-after feature and Xiaomi has done a good job adding it here. To conclude, the Xiaomi Notebook 14e Learning is a great basic laptop. We want to emphasize on the word basic here. You'll be able to do all your basic tasks on it flawlessly. From watching content to writing long emails, you can count on it. But when it comes to heavy usage, then this is not the right choice for you.
Which of course magically also leaves space for our next story, Skullcandy's TWS headset. And these earphones that they have are called the Sesh Evo. Now lots of interesting things, including the fact that they're very nice looking, great battery life of 24 hours, and the other part that the sound is also very, very good, but they are priced very, very well.
If you are a music lover and enjoy watching content on your smart device, then this is a segment for you. Today on the show, we are reviewing Skullcandy's latest true wireless earbuds, Sesh Evo. These promising earbuds are offered by Skullcandy at an amazing price point. The fact that the Sesh Evo comes with Tile app support, which means you can locate these buds if lost, only makes it better. We are excited to turn on our Bluetooth and find out what these buds can do. So let's pair them up and get started with this review. Skullcandy has done a great job with the overall packaging of these TWS earbuds. The case is compact and is really easy to carry around in pockets. There is a button on the case which is used to connect the buds with your device. Additionally, the LED indicators that you see on the case can help you monitor the battery backup that the case is left with. Skullcandy has designed these buds very meticulously. These true wireless earbuds look great once you put them on. They are not at all chunky like some of the other earbuds we have tested before. Sesh Evo sits comfortably and since they are lightweight, they don't bother the user at all. Skullcandy delivers a Sesh Evo with two pairs of extra ear tips, so finding the right fit for you shouldn't be a problem. There are push buttons on each bud that performs their dedicated functions. These buttons help the user to control music and take calls by pressing the bud, making connectivity feasible and accessible. A point to note here is that the buttons were a little hard to press. The pressure can slid the buds further inside the user's ear after multiple taps, only to be pulled out after a while. This might be a nitpick, but Skullcandy could have opted for softer keys on the Sesh Evo. Unlike the previous generations, which came with just one sound output mode of the box, Skullcandy has added three different sound modes with the Sesh Evo: music, movies and podcast. We cranked up a variety of sounds on and heard them in all three EQ settings. To our surprise, it was the movie mode in which we got the best results. The bass was good in the sound and the treble had a lot of life in it as well. The earbuds can also be used individually, which is a standout feature. Each bud has a dedicated microphone, which means you don't have to use both the buds at a given time while you do your chit-chat. The noise cancellation was satisfactory with us. We were able to communicate clearly even while we used the buds outside. Skullcandy gets brownie points for providing great battery life on the Sesh Evo. The earbuds by themselves can last up to 5 hours on a single charge. Additionally, the case can carry up to 19 hours of battery backup, which should be ample to last easily for a week. Both the buds and the case combined together packs up a mileage of 24 hours, making sure you don't have to miss out on your favorite tunes. It's time to close this review with our verdict of the Sesh Evo. At Rs. 4,499, Skullcandy has accomplished the task of providing its celebrated sound quality at an affordable price. If you are on a budget, these TWS earphones should fit right in.
Let's take a quick break right now on the show. When we come back, lots more happening. Next up is a UV sterilizer from Samsung. Now, lots of people usually think that this is only for a phone. Look, it's for everything in your house, your car keys, makeup brushes, anything that can actually fit into this. And a lot of people are using it that way. And you should. I mean, sterilizing all of that is a very, very important thing, especially in current times. Now, this Samsung one has an additional feature that other UV sterilizers don't, and that is that it has wireless charging. Strangely, they didn't build that wireless charger into where it should be, which is on top of the box. They actually built it inside, which I think kind of makes it very fiddly to use.
At a time when everybody is following social distancing, how do you maintain a distance from something that stays with you throughout the day? Your smartphone, a device that is not just your friend, but also a business partner for some. But your significant other might be carrying those harmful germs and bacteria that might put you out for weeks. So how do you deal with this menace? Easy. You give your smartphone a well-deserved UV bath. The box that you see on your screens is a UV sauna that your smartphone might just have been waiting for all this time. This is Samsung's UV sterilizer with wireless charging. So let's cleanse our smartphones right away. The Samsung UV sterilizer comes with a USB Type-A to USB Type-C cable. The packaging on the box says designed for Samsung, but that's not the case. You can sterilize and wirelessly charge smartphones from other smartphone brands as well. The boxy design looks a little chunky for our taste, but since it has hardly any weight to it, we can let this one go. The box comes with dual UV LED lights that can sterilize both top and bottom surfaces of the items that are placed in it. These aren't too big, but according to Samsung, the box can kill up to 99% germs and harmful bacteria lurking on our device. Since these claims have been tested and verified by third-party laboratories, it's safe to bet on this device. The UV sterilizer can be accessed by a single button that can switch the device on and off. The sterilizer takes about 10 minutes to give your device a well-required UVC dosage. Since this sterilizer comes with a 10-watt wireless charger, your phone is not only getting a hygienic hug, but it's also getting juiced up. We do wish that the lid of the box was also capable of fast charging, because that's the one convenient feature that most of its counterparts have. At 3,599 rupees, the Samsung UV sterilizer is not too light on the pocket, but you do get a brand like Samsung taking care of those germs that are laying waste on your phone screens.
That then was the Gadget 360 show for this week. Lots of great stuff coming up next week. I'll see you then.